Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Thursday, SpaceX launched their 70th mission of the year with Starlink 621.
One, ignition, and liftoff. Go Falcon, go Starlink.
The boost which launched this mission, B1076, then landed successfully for the 8th time on the drone ship. Just read the instructions.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy. Stage 1 landing confirmed.
This coming week, we can hopefully expect to see a whole bunch of launches. The next of these should be the Starlink 622 mission, currently scheduled for tomorrow, Monday 9th at 1:06 a.m. UTC, or today, Sunday 8th at 9:06 p.m. EDT. Following that, just a matter of hours later, we can hopefully expect to see another Starlink mission. The Starlink 74 mission is currently scheduled for tomorrow, Monday 9th at 7:23 a.m. UTC or 3:23 a.m. EDT. Then, later in the week, we can hopefully expect to see the long-awaited Psyche mission finally launch. The Falcon Heavy Psyche mission is currently scheduled for Thursday 12th at 2:16 p.m. UTC or 10:16 a.m. EDT. SpaceX posted some information related to having launched 70 missions this year. They said SpaceX has completed 70 Falcon launches so far this year, 20 of which have been supported by our team at Vandenberg. There was some information posted related to a payload on an upcoming Falcon 9 mission. It says Intuitive Machines' first lunar lander is complete and ready to ship for a launch next month, as executives say they are cautiously optimistic about the prospects of a successful landing. There was a cool picture posted on Reddit of a new crew access arm that's been under construction for a while. It says Pad 40 crew arm and view of Cape Orbital Launch Mount in the background. Heading to Boca Chica, here's a view of the launch site. The work on expanding the Star Factory production building is continuing in the production yard. Here's a view of the work continuing on Mega Bay 2 as well. There was some information posted related to Starship and lunar landings. It says, I got word today that our research into the Starship launch pad anomaly is being forwarded uphill to NASA HQ. They are focusing on what we learned about launch landing pad failure modes and how we can make lunar landings safer. There was a Cybertruck recently spotted hauling a Raptor vacuum engine at Starbase. The Cybertruck was spotted hauling another Raptor up and down the highway whilst also being filmed. At some point, a drone got taken out by the RVAC during filming. Starship 25's flaps were seen being tested recently. Ship 25 was also destacked from Booster 9, likely for safety due to stormy conditions. Starship 31 was seen being stacked for the final phase of stacking the prototype. This Booster 14 common dome section was spotted sitting inside Star Factory. To finish up the video today, there are a bunch of closures for this coming week for some possible testing at Starbase. There is currently a scheduled closure for tomorrow, Monday 9th, as well as possible closures, likely backup closures for Tuesday 10th and Wednesday 11th. As always, I have to say thanks to Sean Doherty for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.